Welcome to the session, guys. So in this session, we are going to learn about five new processors. So the first one is log attribute processor. Log attribute processor logs all the attributes of a flow file to the log file. And log file is basically the file which defined in the log directory of the NiFi. So I'll be showing that to you. And when I'm saying log file, what I mean is, if we go to our NiFi directory where we have installed NiFi and we navigate to logs directory, inside that if we do ls, we can see there are three files. So whenever we use log attribute or log message processors, and whenever we log the information related to attribute or message, those are getting stored inside NiFi-app.log file. Okay, so I'll be discussing on how we use those processors and also how we can change the mechanism to use a new file or any other file to log the messages. So the use case of logging the messages can be that, let's say you want to log all the information to a log file, and then you have some reporting tool, or probably you have let's say Splunk or Kibana. Using that, you want to parse all the log messages from the log file, and you want to build some kind of custom report or custom dashboard. That's one scenario. The second scenario can be that you want to log all the information, so whenever your flow fails, you know exactly where the issue is coming from. Okay, so there can be many other use cases as well. So you can log all the logs for audit purpose. So similarly, there can be many scenarios. So we'll be learning about both the processors. And the third one is count text processor. So we'll be using count text processor to count the information of a flow file. So it can count the number of line, it can count the number of words of a flow file, it can count the number of characters of a flow file. And post that, we'll be using attribute to CSV and attribute to JSON processor. So let me put them in order. The first thing which we are going to learn is count text processor. So let's go back to NiFi and let's begin with by creating a process group. I'll name this processor logging and error handling. And then we right click on this processor and we select enter group to go inside that process group. And then in the processor, let's select generate flow file. We want to generate a dummy flow file. And then let's also use count text processor. Generate flow file, let's change the scheduling to 60 seconds. And in the properties, let me change the file size to 1 KB. And in the custom text, let's give some custom text. Okay, so generate flow file is going to generate a file with the content which we have supplied in the custom text. So that's it in this one. In the next processor, let's go to the properties, and in the count line, if you see, it is already set to true, and there are remaining other properties which we can turn to true or false based on our requirement. So if you see this property which says count non-empty lines, do we also want to count non-empty lines? In our case, we do not have any empty lines, but if we do have in a file, or we do have empty lines, it is going to count those. And in the count words, it is set to false, so I'm going to set it to true. And count characters is also set to false, let me set it to true. So it has several other properties as well. So you can read about other properties in NiFi documentation. But basically, whatever property you select to true here, as the output of this processor, all these properties are going to be part of flow file and the relevant value is going to be set. And let me also use funnel. And funnel is just a placeholder in this case. I'm not going to do anything with this. So I will connect count text with the funnel for the success relationship. And for failure, let's do auto termination. So let's run it one time and see what is the output we get. We already have got one flow file, so I'm going to stop this one. And right now, if we see in the list queue and we go on to the attributes, we do not see any other attribute other than file name, path and unique ID. And if you go to view content, we see all the contents of the flow file. So now let's run this count text processor and let's see the output generated by this. So if we see in the queue, if we go on to see the attributes, you can see now other than file name, path and unique ID, we do have other attributes. One is called text.character.count, which is set to 44. So we have 44 characters in this flow file and we have 3 lines written into this flow file and we have a 3 word count which is written in this. So basically, since you see our, we do not have any spaces by default, so all the line is treated as one word. If you have spaces in between them, then each of the space after any words coming the after the space will be treated as a word. So that's the typical behavior. Now if we go into the view content, we'll see the content remains the same. Okay, so now let's say we want to log all these attributes, whatever attributes we see here, we want to log all these attributes in the log file. Right now, if you see, we do not have any properties being logged here. So let me open last 50 lines from this NiFi app.log. Okay, so we do not have any information logged related to the attribute of those files. Okay, so now we are going to make use of log attribute processor. And I'm going to empty this queue and change the relationship. So let's remove this and let's connect count text with log attribute, and then we can connect log attribute with funnel. So let's right click on log attribute and go to configure to see the properties. And if you see in the properties, we have log level which can be set to info, trace, debug, warning or error. So it can be any information which you want to associate along with the log level, you can pass this. So this is just the way of separating your log attribute. So let's say you have a couple of log attributes and in one you want to pass few information, and in that case you can select error. And in this case, let's say I want to just want to log all the attributes for the informational purpose to the log file. So I can just select info. So basically, it doesn't matter which one you select. It is just the way how you want to organize your attributes and pass it on to the flow file. So here I'm going to leave it to info. And in the attributes to log, if you do not want to log all the attributes, if you want to log only few attributes or only the selected attributes to the log file, then you can define the name of those attributes. So we'll be using this later on, so that time I'll show you. So by default, if you do not use this, it is going to log all the attributes, because it makes use of attributes to log by regular expression property, which is set to dot star. Okay, now let's run this one by one. I'm going to stop this, and in the success of the count text processor, as we have previously seen, we should be able to see these. Now our objective is to pass all this information to this log file. Okay, so I've cleared the screen. And let's run this processor. Okay, and in the list view, let's see what is the property of the flow files now. So if you see here in the log attribute, there is no information which has been changed. Okay, and also let's see the content of the flow file. Also, you can see the content of the flow file, there is no information which has been changed. So basically what log attribute does is, it copies all the information of a flow file attribute. Okay, so all these attributes which you see here, it logs it to the flow file. I'm sorry, it logs it to the log file. So if we go here now, in the nifi-app.log, let's do tail-100. We should be having all those attributes which were logged in the flow file. So I have so many other errors as well. Okay, now if you scroll up, you can see this is the information of all the attributes which was generated from the flow file. So if I right click here, go to list view. So all the information which you see here, file name, path and other things, have been logged here. So these are the information, and other than this, there are three standard flow file attributes which also gets written, and those are entry date, lineage start date and file size. Apart from this, whatever is there under this attribute tab gets written into this file. Now if you see, we have so many types of logs getting written into the same file, and it is really difficult if you want to programmatically, you know, find all the logs related with only with the things which you want to see. Okay, so in that case, what we can do is, we can set a prefix in the log attribute. So in the log attribute, if you see, we have log prefix. So let's say I'm going to set it to something like this. Okay, so it can be anything using which you should be able to separate your log attributes with other log messages. Okay, so I will clear the queue, and then we run generate flow file again, and now let's run log attribute processor. And now if I do tail-100 in nifi-app.log file, then now this time you can see I do have a prefix. So all my logs are in between these prefix line or prefix character which you supply. Okay, so now it is very easy to know that this information has come from this log attribute processor. And also when you are using several log attribute processor, you may want to logically arrange all the information using some prefix. So in this case, probably what I could have done is, you can do something like logging and error handling. So now I know that all these attributes are being written from logging and error handling process group. Now I'm going to run this again so we can see the output. Now what we are going to do is, let's disable this log attribute. And now let's use log message. So I'm going to connect count text to log message and select success relationship, and for failure I'm going to select auto terminate. And now in the properties, if you see, we have log level and then we have log prefix and log message. In the log prefix we can put anything, any prefix. So basically I'm saying this process group is logging and error handling, and then in the log message I'm going to write that information passed from count text. Then click apply, and also let's connect this processor to funnel. And now when we start this and also generate flow file, and let's stop this one, and let's do tail-100. Okay, let me clear the screen first. So now whatever the message which we had passed in log message should be coming here in this log file. Okay, as you can already see, it is very challenging to find the information from this log files because there are so many information which is being written into this log file. It is a common log file which is being used by all the processors. So I will probably use grep command to grep the message from this flow file. So what I am doing here is, I am trying to search for this word inside this nifi-app.log file. Okay, so when we actually ran this command previously, what it did is because Unix treated these characters as redirection, and it actually generated the output in a different file. So anyways, so if you see, our message has already been written in the file, and we can see the output around this area. Okay, so it already says logging and error handling information passed from count text. So if I go back to log message, you can see log prefix along with the log message has been submitted to this log file. Okay, and this is the output. So basically, log attribute logs the attribute related information to this log file, and log message logs all the information or any message which you want to write it here in the log file. Now next thing which we want to do is, first of all, let me delete this file. This got created because of that redirection command, so this is not required. Okay, now you might be wondering on what basis all these logging attribute and log message, okay, both of these processors keeps on writing the all the message or the attribute content to NiFi-app.log. Okay, so basically this is the default behavior from all the processor, and it has been defined inside conf directory in the logback.xml file. So if I open this file, and if you scroll up, okay, so here you can see in your file that log attribute and log message for all the info level has been asked or has been redirected to logger. Okay, so this is basically a mechanism to tell that any information which is written by log attribute or log message should be going to the standard log file. And you can very well make changes here, and you can use another file to log all the message from log attribute or log message. Okay, and for that one actually I have already got reference from one of the community posts from Cloudera community, and I have already created a file, and that file is stored in /tmp/logback. Okay, so if we open this file, what I have done is I have inserted one appender name along with modifying the logger name properties. So now if you see, I have a new logger name entry here, okay, which for the first line it says almost whatever we have seen in the previous version, and in the next line it says for the appender reference is the name of the appender class which it should be using, and there you can supply the name of the file. Okay, so here in this line we are saying use appender reference, which is mentioned in status log file reference, and here we are using that status log file, and inside this we are telling the file name here in which it should be logging all the information. So inside logs /nifi-status.log, it is going to log all the information. Okay, so this file nifi-status.log doesn't exist already in the logs directory, but it is going to automatically create that file. So that's the only set of changes which I have made in this file. Now let's replace this file, this logback.xml file, with the file which we have modified. So whenever you make any changes in the configuration file, it is always a good practice to take a backup. So what I'm going to do is, let's take a backup of this log back.xml by renaming it, because now I'm going to copy logback file from other directory to this directory. Okay, so what it has done is the previous logback.xml file has been changed to logback.xml.backup, and then we have a new logback.xml file which has those modified piece of codes, okay, modified piece of lines basically, which we put there in this logback.xml file. So usually whenever you make any changes in the configuration file, you also have to restart NIPA instance. However, in the case of logback.xml, you do not require to restart NIPA instance. Okay, so that is the default behavior. So currently, if you see, we are in the conf directory. Let's go back to logs directory and let's do ls-lrt. Now you can see nipa-status.log. This new file has already been created by the properties which we provided in logback.xml. Okay, now I will stop this log message. And guys, just remember one more thing, the changes which we had made, if I show you knife, let me go back to conf directory. I just want to show you logback .xml file again and wanted to tell you, so whatever changes we are making only in log attribute processor. Okay, so in this example, only the attributes which is written by log attribute is going to come to this new file, nipa-status.log file. Okay, the information which is coming from log message still going to go to nipa-app.log file, because we have not added any new information about this processor in the logback.xml file. But the way to do this is you change this line to log message, okay, or you can use any processor and log their information in any file. So yeah, let me show you this example and let's go back to logs. I'm disabling log message because we are not going to use it and we are only going to use log attribute. So probably log message, since you have already learned, let me delete this one, because for our next example we do not need log message. If I try to delete this one, it will not let me delete as of now. You see, if I try to delete, it is giving me the error because this queue, it's so basically any queue which is preceding this or succeeding this should be empty. And also both the queues preceding and succeeding should be deleted, and then only you can delete the processor. Okay, so funnel, we are still going to use it and we are going to log attribute relationship to funnel for the case of success. Okay, let me start all the processor by right clicking and selecting start. So before this, if you notice, there is already one flow file in the queue. So let me clear this one. Okay, now let's start everything and let's refresh and let's stop everything. Okay, because we already have a flow file in the queue, which means all the information should have come to this log, this nipa-status.log. Okay, so as you can see, this nipa-status.log is having now all the information related to the attribute. Okay, now let's say we do not want to log all this information like this. What we want is, we want to log all of this information in one line in a single key value format. Okay, so for that one, what we can do is we can make use of attribute to JSON processor or attribute to CSV processor. So let's see how this processor works. So first I'm going to use attribute to CSV processor. So I'm going to clear this queue and then we'll be connecting countText to attribute to CSV processor for the case of success, and for the case of failure we are going to select auto terminate. And then we will connect log attribute with attribute to CSV for the case of success. And then we are going to connect log attribute with funnel. Okay, now if we go to attribute to CSV and go to configure, in the properties we have attribute list. So what basically this attribute to CSV does is it picks up all the attributes, all the standard attributes which is available in this previous flow file, and then all the attribute gets combined into one comma separated value. And that new comma separated value is going to be assigned to one new attribute. Okay, so let's see that in action. Let's start everything. Okay, we do not want to start everything because let's see that step by step. Okay, if I refresh, now we have a flow file here. And if I right click in this queue and go to view details and go to attributes, now you can see I have a new attribute which is called CSV data, which is having all the attributes available here separated by comma. Okay, so this is the file name. First attribute which we have is this dot path, and then we can see our file name is here. Then we have value which is related to text.line.count and related to character.count. Now let's say we do not want to use all these attributes, we just want to use this CSV data attribute. So I'm actually copying this name, CSV data name here, and I'm going to use it in the log attribute. So in the log attribute, if you remember, we have something called attributes to log property, and this property I'm going to set it to the name of the attribute which we want to log. Okay, now if we start this, and before this let's start this, and we can see file flow file has been moved to success. So if I cat nify-status.log, now this time I can see all the information has came into one key value pair. Okay, so the attribute name is CSV data and all the values which was part of CSV data has come here. Okay, so attribute to CSV processor basically combines all the attribute to a one value separated by a comma. Okay, now by this I think you would have already understood what is the use of attribute to JSON. So let's see that in action. So attribute to JSON is going to combine all the properties or basically all the attributes and going to merge them into a key value and going to generate only a single attribute which is going to contain these concatenated key value pairs. Okay, so this case, let me disable attribute to CSV. and we are connecting countText to attribute to JSON, and then let's connect this one to log attribute for the case of success. And for the case of failure, let's change attribute to JSON in the setting, change failure to auto terminate. Okay, let me delete these. Okay, and now let's go to right click on attribute to JSON and go to configure, see the properties. And if you see, we have similar properties which we had for attribute to CSV processor. And in attribute to JSON, I'm not putting any attribute list here for now. Let me show you what is the new attribute which gets generated, and then we will use that attribute in the log attribute. So now I'm starting attribute to JSON processor, and in the success queue, if you right click, go to list queue and go on to view details, and then you can see there is a new attribute has been created which is named JSON attribute, which contains the key value pair of all the attributes. So path is set to the path, file name is set to the file name, UUID is set to the UUID, and so forth. Okay, now this attribute I'm going to define into log attribute. So in the attribute to logs, we have changed it now to JSON attribute. Let me clear this queue. Now I'm going to start everything again, and let's stop it because we can already see one flow file which has been moved from log attribute to next queue. And now this time if I do cat nify-status.log, I can see that all the attribute has came to JSON attribute. In the value, I have all the JSON data, okay, which is a key value pair of all the attribute information. Now let's say we do not want all the information, all we care about is path and the file name, okay, or let's say all we care about is the text word count. So for this one, you need to go to attribute to JSON, and in the configuration here you can supply attribute list. Okay, so here you can supply the list of attribute which you want to produce your JSON list from. So in my case, let's just change it to file name, or let's change it to text word count. So our expectation is whatever information we had in text word count, that is the only thing which is going to come into this JSON attribute property, and that's the only information next time which is going to be logged here. Okay, so let's run this one by one so we can see the output. Let's go to the list queue now and go on to view details. And now if you see on the attribute, we have only captured attribute is text word count. Okay. And if I start log attribute, it is going to write the same information to our log file. Okay, by mistake I clicked on leave group, so I entered again to the group. So now here, let me clear the screen first. And if I do cat hyphen nipy dot our basically our status log file, so now we can see we have key and values logged here, and in the value we have only one attribute information which has been logged. Okay, so that is how you make use of log attribute, log message, and attribute to CSV or attribute to JSON processor. So attribute to CSV and attribute to JSON is pretty much used independently, and you can use it for any case, not only for the cases where you want to write the information in the log message or log attribute. So this can be used independently based on the use case which you have. So hope the session was useful. Stay tuned for next session.